In this video, we're going to practice our properties of logs by writing the following problems as a single logarithm. Okay, we're going to practice using our properties of logs by writing each expression as a single logarithm. So here's the first one. 1 half log of x base 4 minus 3 log of x minus 1 base 4. So the first thing you want to do is deal with these coefficients in front of the logs. And remember, we put that as an exponent of the what you're taking a log of. So this becomes the log base 4 of x to the 1 half. And the second one is going to be minus log base 4 of x minus 1 cubed. All right, now that we don't have any coefficients in front of either log, I see this is subtraction, so we can write that as the log of the quotient. So this will just be the log base 4. Now the numerator is x to the 1 half. Now if you want, you could leave that as x to the 1 half, or you could write that as square root of x, because that's usually how you would write x to the 1 half. And in the denominator will be the x minus 1 cubed, and now I've written this as a single log. Okay, here's the next one. We're going to start out the same way. Let's take the exponents. Remember, you could, the coefficients in front of the log, if you've written as the exponents, right? So this will give me, I hope you're doing this on your own at the same time or even before me. So this would be log base 5 of m squared minus, this will be log base 5 of 8 to the 2 thirds. And this will be log of m plus 1 to the 1 half. Now, what can we do with this log base 5 of 8 to the 2 thirds? 8 to the 2 thirds, you could actually simplify that, because that means the cube root of 8 squared. Remember, the root's at the bottom, so you take the cube root of 8, which is 2, and then square it. So this is really the same as log base 5 of m squared minus log base 5 of 4 plus, now notice I did not write log base 5 here, so I can't write this one as a single log. So I'm going to put base 5, because that was just a mistake on my part. I meant to put log base 5. Okay, so they would all have to be the same base in order to do the next step, which was to combine them into a single log. So if they're all log base 5, the ones that have positives go in the numerator, and they get to be multiplied by each other, and the one that has a minus sign goes in the denominator. So in the numerator, I'll have an m squared times the square root of m plus 1, and in the denominator, I'll have a 4, and now again, I've written this as a single log. Now I'm going to show you one more thing. See this minus log of 5, base 5 of 4? That minus 1 could be thought of plus a negative 1. So look and see what happens if I rewrite it. All right, so here we have this. See this minus sign here? I could think of that as a minus 1, and you could think of that as plus a negative 1. So the negative 1 could go on that exponent of 4. So what if I had written it as plus log base 5 of 4 to the negative 1, and I still have this log base 5 of square to m plus 1, then what you have here is they're all plus signs. So if I write it as a single log at this point, I can either at this point change this to 1/4. Remember, 4 to the negative 1 is 1/4, or I could leave it as 4 to the negative 1 for now and multiply everything together. So I have an m squared times the 4 to the negative 1 times the square root of m plus 1. I'm going to put the 4 to the negative 1 first, because we usually write the coefficient out in front, times square root of m plus 1, right? But then, of course, this 4 to the negative 1 means it could be going in the denominator. So that would give me m squared square root of m plus 1 over 4. Now that's the same answer we had before. Check it out. Log base 5 of m squared times the square root of m plus 1 over 4. So when there's a minus sign in front, that's why it ends up going in the denominator. And this is just an alternate way of changing them all to plus signs. You eventually would have that go in the denominator. Not saying this is easier, just saying it's another way to get to exactly the same place. All right, here's another one. So again, we're going to begin by taking the coefficients here and putting them as exponents. So this gives me the first one, log. Now notice, I do not show the base here. So remember that means base 10. So these are all base 10. So I don't need to write the log. So that's log of n squared minus log of x squared to the third power plus log of 5 to the 1/3. Now, actually, depending on where in the series of my videos you're watching, I may not have explained that if there's no base, it represents base 10, but that's the truth. So if you don't see anything, it just means it's the same as writing base 10. That's called common log. So you could leave it off when it's base 10. All right, so now we have just log subtracted and added together here. So the ones that are added, plus signs in front, get to go in the numerator. So it's just the log. Now let's be careful. What do we have in the numerator? We have an n squared times, now I have an x squared to the third power. So remember you multiply exponents, that's x cubed. I'm sorry, x to the sixth. And oops, sorry, there was a minus sign. I have the n squared, but this goes in the denominator because I have a minus in front of it. So x to the sixth goes in the denominator, and a 5 to the 1/3, well, how could you write 5 to the 1/3? That's the same thing as the cube root of 5. Now, normally you would write the cube root of 5 in front of the variable, so I'm just going to rewrite it that way. It's not that it's wrong the other way, it just looks funny. So cube root of 5 times n squared. The n squared is not under the cube root, right? Over x to the sixth. So I've written it all as a single log. And again, if you want, you could always write the base of 10. That's up to you. So this is optional when you have base 10. All right, we're going to write this as a single log. So let's begin by putting the exponents on each of these. So we've got log base 5 of x to the seventh plus log base 5 of x to the 2/3 minus log base 5 of the quantity 2x to the third power. Now I'm going to use my quotient and product rules here. So these first two, which are added, is the same thing as log base 5 of x to the 7th times x to the 2/3. That'll be the numerator. And in the denominator, I'm going to have the 2x to the 3rd power, which if we simplify that, that would be 8x cubed. Now I can simplify, see all these x's here? All the bases with x's? I could simplify that as well. So I'm going to have an 8 in the denominator, but this is going to be x to the what power? Well, in the numerator, I could add 7 and 2/3. Remember, you would add the exponents and I would subtract the 3. So basically, the steps are I'm going to add the 7, add the 2/3, and I'm going to subtract the 3, this exponent down here. So that gives me 4 and 2/3. So that's going to be the exponent on that x, and if you write that instead as an improper fraction, that would be 14/3. So x to the 14/3 over 8. So a little bit trickier problem that's now written as a single log. If you want, you could put a parenthesis around that. So here we go.